Chancellor Valorum, otherwise known as Finis Valorum, was the Supreme Chancellor at the time of the Phantom Menace, and was succeeded by Supreme Chancellor Palpatine many years before the start of the Clone Wars. What happened to him after? Well, the answer is the fact that he's actually Snoke. No, but in all seriousness, what really happened to him after, and what did he do? All this in today's video. So first, we will be covering the answer in canon material. After being succeeded by Palpatine, he had kept low and had resided in his Republic estate, which is located on the Republic capital planet, Coruscant. When the time came and the Clone Wars was near its end, he helped Yoda conduct an investigation on the disappearance of Sifo Dyas, a Jedi Master that was sent on a mission nearly a decade before and hadn't returned. Valorum told Yoda all that he knew and needed to know about the mission and Sifo Dyas. That is the extent of his story in canon. Now, in Legends, it is a completely different story. After being succeeded by Chancellor Palpatine, Valorum spent 2 years hiding until the heat and distaste from him had died out. Valorum had later joined a group that had helped refugees relocate their homes after they had been destroyed. Near the beginning of the Clone Wars, however, Valorum had started to take notes of Palpatine's actions, and had discussed his worries with Bail Organa. He had discussed with Organa that he was worried of Palpatine becoming a dictator-like ruler with all the power that he had gained. Because of his perception, Valorum had decided it was best to leave Coruscant and feared that he would be assassinated by Palpatine in the near future because of his concerns. Organa originally dismissed Valorum and his ideas, but eventually began to worry too after being subtly threatened by Palpatine in his office after not agreeing to pass a bill. Before Valorum had left, he met with Organa and some of the other senators, and they talked about their growing concerns. But Valorum had not agreed to help them, and as he flew away, his ship had blown up, thus making Organa's concerns completely cemented, and thereout he went against Palpatine with all the power he had. So guys, there you have it. That is what happened to Valorum in both canon and Legends continuity. I think the Legends version is much better, but be sure to let me know down in the comments which version you liked better. If you enjoyed the video, be sure to hit that like button to show your support, and be sure to comment down below what you guys want to see next. Lastly, be sure to subscribe, as it really helps me out a ton, a lot more than you may think. And as always, may the Force be with you all, until next time.